What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to this episode of G4 Outdoors. Today we're going to be reviewing the number one electric blower brand, the Toro 60 volt battery powered cordless blower. First off, I want to give a huge shout out to Toro and a big thank you to Toro for sending all these products out here for me to review. Guys, go ahead and hit the Toro playlist to check out all of these. I still have the mower to review. I've done the hedge trimmer. I've done the weed eater. And today we're going to be doing the 60 volt cordless battery powered blower. So go ahead and hit that playlist. Not now, when the video is over, because these are actually very, very impressive products. I would definitely tell you guys if they were underrated or anything like that. There are some flaws, kind of ergonomic flaws on these that I'm not too fond of, but they can easily be overlooked. Some of you may not even recognize some of these problems. It's just in the handle. It's the only thing I can nitpick on. So anyways, let's get into this box, do a quick unboxing review, and we're gonna test it in this video. Okay, while I'm unboxing this, I wanna go ahead and talk about this a little bit. This is a 60 volt system. You know, that is a lot of voltage for a lot of these battery powered equipment. Most of them are running in the 40 volt range. The 60 volt is going to give you a ton more power. What is this rated at? As far as power goes, this has 605 cubic feet per minute of air force and 115 miles per hour of air. Now, I do have another battery powered equipment, and it's very equivalent to my Steel BG55. If the 40 volt is equivalent, I'm expecting this thing to outperform the Steel. Again, guys, stick around later on in some videos because I will be testing this against Gas Power and another brand. So anyways, back into the box. You do have an instruction manual. If you're feeling frisky, go ahead and read through that. Right off the bat, we're gonna have your charger. Something I do like about these chargers is they are very big. You do have a light indicator here in the middle. You have a bad battery, a good battery, charging and charged indicators on here. It does have a fan inside of here. That way it's going to cool your battery and the machine itself while it's running. Lithium ion batteries is something that you don't want to overheat or anything like that. They're very delicate. Kind of dangerous if you do stuff wrong with them. So a fan inside of here is a perfect thing to have in there. They have padded feet on the bottom. It has two holes right here to where you can mount this on your wall if you wanted to. Personally, I just have mine on a shelf sitting down just like this. Works just fine. Slap your battery on here. Dig a little deeper. And then we have our battery. This is your 60 volt, 2.5 amp hour, 135 watt hours battery. These batteries are very small for the amount of power that they have in them. It's very comfortable, the battery is. It has rubber molded handles on it, so it's easy to grab on and off of your machine, whichever one you're using. And this is interchangeable between the hedge trimmers, the string trimmer, the blower, and possibly, if you're in a pinch, that can go on the mower. And later on in the year, I will be reviewing a chainsaw, so this will be able to slap right on the chainsaw as well. I kind of skipped out of order, but the price on this is $200 including the battery and $140 without the battery. And you know, here's where you can save a ton of money. You can buy three of these units without the battery, save yourself a ton of money. And like I say, this one battery is interchangeable with all of the products. I wouldn't recommend using the battery on this mower, but I think that it's capable. We'll find out when I get in this review. But that's one thing that is really handy about saving money on buying one of these without a battery. That way, you already have a battery. In my experience so far, let's see, when I was trimming hedges, I went through a quarter of a battery. And when I was trimming, I went through a half a battery. And if you go back and watch that video, that's a lot of trimming that I did in that video. So I truly think that I can use all of these products with one battery in one setting. And again, stick around for some more videos because I will be testing that theory out. Back into the box. Okay, so you got a big old tube right here. Just a big old black tube. And last, we do have our blower right here. All right, first impression, first time seeing it with you guys. It's a little large, but comfortable. Just the body right here. That's the part that's a little bit large. But it may need to be large to get all of that airflow through here. That is so nice. Okay, you do have I'll figure this out. There's a button up here. So there is a cruise control here on the side. Let me scoot up. So there is a cruise control right here. Watch that trigger. So as that goes in, you can set this at a certain amount of blow that you want, and it'll stay right there. That is a handy feature. A lot of these, it's either on or off, and a high and low. This is the first one that I've seen that actually has a full trigger pull like that, and power band throughout the whole thing, and a cruise control. I like this cruise control a lot. Haven't even used it, but that is a handy feature for when you're like blowing a bunch of leaves and stuff. Your hand just gets a little bit sore from holding that trigger constantly. One thing that I mentioned about the ergonomics on these, it's something that could be cleaned up a little bit. I didn't have a problem with the hedge trimmers. I had a minor problem with the weed eater, and that may just be the way that I'm holding it. But as you can see right here, this crease right here, needs to be sanded down just a little bit. Now, like I say, that might not be a problem. I haven't actually ran this for a certain amount of time to know. We will find out what this blue button right here is. That might be a turbo for your wind. Let's get this thing assembled real quick. Now, assembly is going to go super quick. There's not really much to it. Slap the black tube on there and you are ready to go. Again, in my experience, these batteries will come with a 25% full battery. Nope, this one's completely dead. Let's get a new one. Okay, got a new one out, and I want to show you real quickly that these do have battery gauges on them. Press the battery button, and this will light up all the way. And depending on where your battery level is, it will back down dot for dot for dot to show you exactly the level of battery. But this one is staying all the way up, so it is a full charge. So if you have a couple of batteries, go ahead and throw the dead one on your battery charger. Put your new battery in, and this, it really is just that easy. Your blower is ready to go. Now let's see if I'm right about this turbo button up here or not. Yes, it is a turbo button. That probably gives you 30% more power, it felt like just then. And as a matter of fact, this was leaning up against my stomach here and I could feel all that wind being sucked in here. So the body size on this probably does need to be as big as it is so that it can get that air in here. There's a big fan here. Just the amount of air that it was blowing over there. That's a lot of air coming through here. Now let's go outside. Let's make a little mess on the sidewalks and clean it up. Now what we're going to be doing is two properties, a double drive, and two links of sidewalk. So that's going to be more than what most of you might have, might not. I'm not saying it's two properties. So I'm not saying, a single property probably isn't going to be this much work. So I know that this is going to handle it as far as the battery life goes. What I want to see is if this is going to clean the edges out. I'm going to edge the sidewalks, and I'm going to mow. I'm going to blow everything into the sidewalks and onto the street. Don't worry about it, it's getting cleaned right up, and we'll see how this works. All right, so currently the grass is a little on the dry side, so I couldn't get those real heavy wet clumps to come out here. But there is a lot of debris in these cracks from where I edged it. So let's run along here and see how well this cleans out the edges. See just how much power is in here to get these edges cleaned out, sidewalk cleaned off. All right, so that first pass, what I noticed is it does have a lot of airflow. This will be great for cleaning up leaves. I wish that it had an extension on here to make this hole just a little bit smaller. That way it'll give you a harder press on exactly where you're blowing. It's a little bit widespread. And don't get me wrong, it did its job. As you can see, it cleaned that crack out just fine, or that edge. But this big diameter is really good for airflow and getting a lot of leaves out. So not only is this going to be good for your edges blowing off your sidewalks, this is going to be really great for the leaf cleanup time just because of the amount of airflow that's coming out of here. Let me take you with you and we'll clean up the other side of this. Okay, so if you saw me blow the grass over two lanes of driveway on that driveway over there, that is definitely more power than my gas-powered blower. And like I say, it's great power. It's a lot of volume. It's not so much precision pinpoint power. It's just a big volume of air coming out. So it is great for cleaning the grass off the sidewalks, but what I'd really like to see more on this is actually for leaves and a smaller tube on here. It would help out. It's not bad. As you can see, it did the job just fine. Battery life, it's not even something to talk about. It's still got full power. The one I'm gonna be testing this up against later on in another video, I can do my property twice before I have to recharge it. So no comparison on the power of it. Again, guys, it's a blower. It's just going to be a short video. Not much to talk about. It blows a ton of air. I'd hate to spoil it, but I will be testing this up against some others, and they're not going to fare too well. So anyways, guys, please hit that Toro playlist. I have all of their battery-powered equipment coming out. So I hope you liked the video. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, leave a comment down below. Tell me what you guys think about the battery powered equipment. I will see you in the next one, and that'll probably be on Monday.
Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I just dream of fishing while I'm going through my workday. I listen to my boss, though he's driving me berserk. Damn it, I can't take much more because my brain is really hurting. And now the bank is always calling and I don't know what to do. And I haven't bought a crankbait since like 1992. But the bass are out there schooling and they're